ट्रांसमिशन क्षमता में वृद्धि हो, बिजली के वितरण के लिए बुनियादी ढांचे में सुधार करना हो, ऊर्जा संरक्षण पर बल देने का मामला हो, या फिर आधुनिकीकरण और उपभोक्ताओं पर केंद्रित नई पहल करने और नीतियों को अपनाने का विषय हो। अब तक भारत सरकार शहरी और ग्रामीण क्षेत्रों में बिजली वितरण के बुनियादी ढांचे में सुधार हेतु दीनदयाल उपाध्याय ग्राम ज्योति योजना, IPDS, प्रधानमंत्री सहज बिजली हर घर योजना, सौभाग्य तथा अन्य योजनाओं के अंतर्गत लगभग 2,00,000 करोड़ रुपए की परियोजनाएं स्वीकृत कर चुकी है, जिनमें 1,43,017 करोड़ रुपए के केंद्रीय वित्त पोषण अनुदान का प्रावधान किया गया है और 1,17,109 करोड़ रुपए का भारत सरकार द्वारा अनुदान राज्यों को दिया जा चुका है। IPDS योजना में शहरी क्षेत्रों में उपारेषण और वितरण नेटवर्क को मजबूत करने और सरल तकनीकी और वाणिज्यिक नुकसान को कम करने के लिए वितरण ट्रांसफार्मर फीडर उपभोक्ताओं की मीटरिंग का प्रावधान है। मैं सभी दीनदयाल उपाध्याय ग्राम ज्योति योजना के अंतर्गत देश के सभी गांवों के विद्युतीकरण कार्यक्रम और प्रधानमंत्री सहज बिजली हर घर योजना के अंतर्गत देश के 2,81,00,000 घरों को 18 महीने के कम समय में बिजली कनेक्शन देकर देश में सर्वत्र बिजली पहुंचाने के लक्ष्य के सफल क्रियान्वयन का साक्षी रहा हूं। यह सचमुच बड़ा ही सराहनीय कार्य है और इन उपलब्धियों के लिए मैं आप सभी को बधाई देता हूं। दीनदयाल उपाध्याय ग्राम ज्योति योजना और IPDS के अंतर्गत उपभोक्ताओं के लिए बिजली आपूर्ति की गुणवत्ता और विश्वसनीयता में सुधार हेतु ग्रामीण और शहरी दोनों क्षेत्रों में बड़े पैमाने पर सिस्टम सुदृढ़ीकरण के कार्य किए गए हैं। इन कार्यों के परिणामस्वरूप देश भर के ग्रामीण क्षेत्रों में बिजली की उपलब्धता 2015 में लगभग 12.5 घंटे से बढ़कर 22.5 घंटे तक हो गई है और क्षेत्रीय शहरी क्षेत्रों में बढ़कर 23 घंटे 36 मिनट हो गई है। ये आपके और हमारे सामूहिक प्रयासों का परिणाम है। मीटरिंग हो, बिलिंग हो, बुनियादी ढांचे का रखरखाव हो या फिर उपभोक्ताओं की शिकायतों को दूर करना आदि हो, वितरण क्षेत्र के प्रदर्शन के आधार पर ही उपभोक्ताओं की सोच बनती है। स्पष्ट है कि बिजली वितरण कंपनियों को राजस्व की प्राप्ति और अपने स्थायित्व को बनाए रखने के लिए देखा गया है कि राज्यों की वितरण संस्थाओं को सकल तकनीकी और वाणिज्य नुकसान का मुख्य कारण बिलिंग संग्रह दक्षता में कमी है, जो कि बहुत ही कुछ मानवीय हस्तक्षेप पर निर्भर है। इस कमी को दूर करने हेतु RDSS योजना में प्रीपेड रूप से 2024-25 तक लगभग 25 करोड़ स्मार्ट मीटर लगाने का लक्ष्य है, जिससे AT&C धारणियों को मूलभूत कारण बिजली संग्रह दक्षता में सुधार की आशा है। इस योजना के अंतर्गत बिजली वितरण के क्षेत्र को आने वाले भविष्य के लिए तैयार करने हेतु सुधारों से जुड़े प्रमुख मामलों का विकास रूप से समाधान किया जा रहा है। बिजली वितरण के क्षेत्र में घाटे में कमी लाने और ढांचे के आधुनिकीकरण और सुदृढ़ीकरण के उद्देश्य से आर्मर्ड केबल, HVDC, AB केबलिंग, फीडर बाइफर्केशन, फीडर सेग्रीगेशन, IT/OT कार्यों, सब सिस्टमों की दक्षता बढ़ाने और उनके नवीकरण के कार्य पर विशेष बल दिया गया है। बिजली का क्षेत्र अपने स्थायित्व के लिए वाणिज्यिक और लोगों के उत्थान के लिए सामाजिक दोनों भूमिका निभाता है। जहां तक एक और बिजली क्षेत्र की वित्तीय व्यवहार्यता को बनाए रखने के लिए इसकी कीमत लागत के अनुरूप होनी चाहिए, वहीं दूसरी ओर हमारे देश के उद्योगों को बढ़ती प्रतिस्पर्धा के बीच सस्ती बिजली की भी जरूरत है। इससे व्यवसाय करने में आसानी होगी और देश में विदेशी निवेश आएगा, जिससे रोजगार के नए अवसर पैदा होंगे और देश के नागरिकों के जीवन स्तर में सुधार होगा।
वी मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड दैट द पावर सेक्टर इज द की टू एवरीथिंग। द कंट्री कैन नॉट प्रोग्रेस अनलेस इट हैज एनर्जी, अनलेस इट हैज पावर। एवरीथिंग इज इलेक्ट्रिफाइड टुडे, एवरीथिंग इज गेटिंग इलेक्ट्रिफाइड। ऑल आवर इंडस्ट्रीज आर ऑन पावर, ऑल आवर trains, everything runs on power. Without power, as in a country is like a third world country or radio of darkness. Now the sector has to be viable. That's the key. If the sector is not viable, it won't run, it won't survive. Otherwise, the generation will stop. They will not be able to pay for the coal, they will not be able to pay their installments to the banks. They will become sick. No new investment will come. Our demand is growing, and if you don't have investment coming, you will have a real crisis. This is our country. We have to fight for it. So there are some political elements which are misguided, who are not concerned about the future of the country. What they want is votes today. I mean, votes are important, but the future of the country is more important. We must do it. And because Lord has no remain with power, so that was not counted. People will suffer. Our country will suffer. We replaced almost about 7 lakh circuit kilometers of HT lines and similar 5-6 lakh circuit kilometers of HT lines. When they're frail, when they get old, you won't have the money to replace it. ये कब तक चलेगा साहब कैसे चले एंड द फॉल्ट इज आउट योर सेल्फ माइंड हम लोग अपनी बात रखते थे वी डोंट से व्हाट नीड्स टू बी सेड एंड इफ यू डोंट से व्हाट नीड्स टू बी सेड यू आर नॉट वर्थ योर सॉल्ट प्लेन एंड सिंपल द फॉर्मूला इज सिंपल You buy electricity and you supply electricity. Whatever electricity you buy, you must recover the cost of that. And plus, you must recover the distribution charges because you have to maintain the system. You must recover the transmission charges. That's the cost of supply you must recover. And if the state government wants to give free electricity, so be it. Let them pay that cost of supply. Now why is it not happening? It is not happening because we don't place accounts for the state government. We don't say that, okay, this is the cost of supply. You want the tariff to give this. This is the gap. And this is the subsidy which you have to pay. You don't do that. And the regulator also, you don't place your case before the regulator and the regulator does not. Put it in the system. Now, that's not going to cut. You would have noted a number of steps which we are taking. And we have some ambitions. Let me first state our ambitions. Our ambition is to make the power sector strong, viable, and ready for the coming century. We want to make it modern. We want 24/7. We want to do away with all generators. I don't want any generator anywhere. And reliable supply. We want to do away with all voltage stabilizers. Load setting should be something which, you know, people will say that, okay, 10 years back there was some, you know, blackout or load setting. That's what we want. And we want power at competitive prices. You can schedule it when you need it because storage will be there. So this will be as good as your thermal power. So you won't have to sort of, you know, bear the burden of having unnecessarily large quantities of intermittent power. Now those who have already put in place large quantities of intermittent power, I would advise them to start putting in place storage. So that will make intermittent power value. We have already started that. We have already come out with RFPs for 1000 megawatt hours. Here, ATPC has come out with a bid similarly. So you should also come out with a bid. We are coming out clarification where we are saying that this is the status of storage. That will be replaced by the rules. Ultimately, what that will do? It will reduce the cost of power supply to the people, number one. Number two, it will lead to a better environment. I also have noticed that something which should have become a people's movement has not started. has not really taken off, and that is rooftop. I hope we'll cover rooftop as well in the forum. So let's begin with the deliberations. But basically, this is the mission which we have. We have the mission is make it viable. The mission is energy transformation. The energy transformation will help us in making it viable. Agriculture load goes to solar or renewables. So the viability increases and your problems reduce. I have one more thing I'd like to close with, just one more point. I have seen states turned up and difficult states, hard states. Haryana, they've done it up. Assam, they've turned up. They are difficult states. Now if they can turn up, can you? In Assam, the chief minister visits the DISCOM once a month and just looks at the collection figures. But not whom? The chief secretary, and the chief minister has made the chief secretary the head of the holding company, Assam Power Distribution, Assam Power Development Corporation, subsidy, etc. Great, great. Just make sure that that bill is circulated. Thereafter, once you do that, I can tell you that ultimately the state government will pay. The state government is not paying because you don't. Now for that we have made energy accounting compulsory. What is going to happen is that now there is going to be a cause and effect. And gradually you will see this in whatever steps we have taken. We are putting in place through cause and effect. So that if you are making losses, you will not get any loans from REC and PFC. And we also returned to RBI to advise all the banks. Because naturally, if you are making losses, you can't repay the loans. So you can't fund it that way. If you don't pay to the GenCos, the power will switch on. This fiat has already been given to all the CPSC. They will switch off power, cut off power. So, when something like this happens, so the state government does not give the entire subsidy, and when the government departments don't pay, you have to send a note to the state government saying that this is a situation, we can't pay the GenCos, and the rule now is that the GenCos will switch it off. And we are not only going to switch it off. You can't replace it with any other power. It can't be that you keep the outstandings of XYZ of DVC and then replace it with power from NTPC. You can't. We are going to change the system so that if you have outstanding dues and your power has been cut because of those outstanding dues by X generator, you can't buy power from Y generator to replace it. That power will go till you pay the bill. That's a solution. So this is something which I want you to tell your political ministers. That look, if the government departments don't pay, if you don't give us a subsidy, this is the gap, so the power will switch off. Once you have this cause and effect established in their mind, then they'll think five times before announcing subsidy, and they'll ask the finance secretary, I said, tell me, do we have enough money? Can I announce this much of subsidy? ऐसे नहीं होगा कि हाँ आकर के बोल दिया कि साहब सुन 4 रुपये पर यूनिट हम दे दें या 300 units फ्री दे दें, ऐसा नहीं होगा. Now that is what we have to bring about, and that is for national interest. For us, the nation comes first. For me, the nation comes first. Tell me about you. For you also, the nation must come first. So you place this before your political masters in case that is not happening. That is part one. Part two is improving your own efficiency. Your billing efficiency, your collection efficiency. Now for that we are going to put in the prepaid meters, smart prepaid meters, so that will help. And you must roll it. And you must roll it out. Or, in the priority areas first, areas where you have extra losses first. It has to be rolled off at Oxford, so that if it does not work, say what is running it? If it is renewable, it is not, it is renewable. And if power sets up wind energy or solar energy, it will not be renewable. क्या साहब, ये सिर्फ हमारे ही देश में हो सकता है? पूरी दुनिया में यू नो हाइड्रो रिन्यूअल था, यू नो शाश्वत फ्रॉम द बिगिनिंग ऑफ टाइम हाइड्रो हैज रिन्यूअल फॉर द वर्ल्ड वर्ल्ड एक्सेप्ट इन इंडिया व्हेन यू रिकॉग्नाइज स्मॉल हाइड्रो एज रिन्यूअल एंड लार्ज हाइड्रो इज नॉट रिन्यूअल. आज साहब बताइए, ये होगा बोगस बाजी का लिमिट. खैर ये 18 बजे करेक्ट हो गया, तो हाइड्रो इज रिन्यूअल. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी एस्टैब्लिश 150 गीगावाट्स and another 63 gigawatts of renewable. I'm talking about renewable, I'm not talking about non-fossil fuel. That means I'm not including nuclear. And 63 gigawatts is under installation. So that makes it 200 and some gigawatts already. So we have to do 300 gigawatts more. And I think actually it is not 500 gigawatts of renewable, it's 500 gigawatts of non-fossil fuel. So we have about 6,780 megawatts of nuclear, and we have another about 12,000-13,000 megawatts of nuclear under construction. So you take that into account. So by and large, out of 300 gigawatts, you take out another, say, let us say about 20 gigawatts nuclear over later. So I think we have to do another about 280 gigawatts. So the revised RPO will be circulated. Are you know taking it up to 2030 to meet this commitment which our country has made? It's a legal binding commitment made in Glasgow, and that RPO has to be achieved. Once you know you have your agriculture water taken care of, your viability will suddenly improve. The viability of the state government will improve, and the farmer will get power during it. And we are also giving you the money for feeder solarization. I mean for, you know, the agriculture feeder wherever you have not as yet constructed agriculture feeders. Under DVR, I think we constructed about 160,000 circuit kilometers, 122,000 circuit kilometers of agriculture feeders. But still, there will be states where all areas have not been covered with agriculture feeders. So find out which are the areas where people are extracting groundwater for agriculture irrigation and where the agriculture feeder has not been separated, and do the separation under this new scheme. We'll give you the money, this is a priority. So whichever area people are extracting groundwater for agriculture irrigation and it is, you know, the agriculture feeder has not been separated under the new scheme. So you don't have to spend money on that. And solarization we are giving you 100 kusum. So this will be a huge one. So now coming back to viability is not very difficult. It's not really very difficult. You have to improve your billing efficiency, you have to improve your collection efficiency, you have to make sure that the tariff is cost effective. And whatever subsidy the state government wants to give, they can give. But the tariff has to be cost effective. And thereafter the state government can say that, okay, the average your tariff across the board is let's say 6 rupees, and I want to give people under the poverty line power at 1 rupee, fine. Good, great. So you said that 5 rupees is the gap. So many million units have been supplied to people under the poverty line. So your subsidy bill on account of that comes to this. Just send it. Where's the problem? Our problem is that you are not professional, we are not professional. That's the basic problem. We don't do our job professionally. Professional baniye janab. Apna kaam nahi kar sakte hain. Aapka hisab ke paas hisab nahi. Don't even have accounts. Karte kya? You are supposed to be officers. Hai na? Do your job. And do your job professionally. You do that, the problems will be taken care of. The end objective is that. And now I'm going to make everything conditional. Everything is going to be conditional on your making the system viable. Now the government have also made a commitment of putting in place 500 gigawatts of renewable energy capacity by 2030.
So if you allow, we'll re-begin. We had had a discussion on Rajasthan. So perhaps Rajasthan can again tell you what their problems are in that.
Right. Rajasthan, I just want to hear from you. You see that what you have achieved and what is the problem? In Kusum, where is Rajasthan? Haan.
Sir, Kusum A or B, see, the component of Rajasthan will be number one here, sir. Component A mein sir, aap logon ne abhi tak progress
kitna target tha, kitna hua?
Sir, hamara jo full capacity sir, hamare 722 megawatt ke humne sir award kar diye sir. Usme 184 PPA we already executed sir. अभी वी हैव इंस्टॉल 12.5 मेगावाट ऑफ लेवल प्लांट सर. सर वी आर डूइंग बेस्ट बट वी आर फेसिंग फ्यू प्रॉब्लम्स सर. आई हैव ऑलरेडी हाईलाइटेड सर.
रिमेनिंग विल बी पेड टू हिम एवरी क्वार्टर प्रोवाइडेड द सिस्टम इज फंक्शन. इट डज नॉट फंक्शन और सपोज इंस्टेड ऑफ फंक्शनिंग 100% और 99% वी नंबर वन प्लीज डोंट. You will set a yardstick that it has to function 99.5% smart meter meter. And any shortfall will mean a cut. And any shortfall of more than 1% or 2%, put this about 5. Any shortfall of more than 2% or 3%, whatever sort of norm you want to fix, will mean that quarter's installment will go. That is one. The second is that I have said, and I'm waiting for that. File alone. I have said that now the bids, only those companies can participate who have demonstrated that their system works. Just so to me. Right. So they'll have to demonstrate a test bid. And your people will go and see that yes, the system works. The system works means that it must switch off automatically when the credit runs out. When it is recharged, it must switch on automatically. It must convey data to the head end so that you can program it wherever there is any change in the tariff, etc. So the system must be. And only those companies will be allowed to participate who have a tried and tested system. But this is something which will take care of your billing and collection efficiency. Another thing which we have brought, which we are going to discuss today first, is to help you in so far as the agriculture sector is concerned. You see, I am doing anything and everything to help you. And the rules which I am tightening is also to help you. I wanted to show this to your government, to your minister, to your power minister, and say that now this is the rule. So that will help you. So what we have done is this Kusum. We brought in a system of feeder solarization. We want you to put the entire agriculture sector on solar. You can do it either through the CapEx mode. I will give you 30% grant and 70% loan from REC, PFC, NABARD at 6%, 7%. Whatever is your agriculture subsidy, that goes to repay the loan. It gets paid off in max 5.5 years. After that, your agriculture subsidy is a saving. You get extra income because the power, when it is not used for irrigation, is available to you free of cost. You have not paid a single penny, and a farmer has not paid a single penny. So actually, in theory, the farmer should get power free. My recommendation is that you charge him 50% per unit. If you do it on a CapEx model, if you do it on a model of RESCO, which is also possible, declare that in 2018. But the rest of the world has always declared all hydro as renewable. In our country, there was this misconception that when MNRE was separated, so probably power did not want to part with large hydro. So they transferred only small hydro to MNRE.